Hey guys, it's Rich with Pitlanes.com. Today I'm going to be comparing a couple of recently released mods for Assetto Corsa, one from Racing Studio and the other from ACFL. I've never heard of either modding group and I'm not affiliated with either of them. Politics be damned, I don't know if I'm going to land either of them in trouble with what they've chosen to mod. But really that's not my problem, they're putting it in the public domain. I like sim racing, I make YouTube videos, I'm going to check them out and show people what they're about, and if they want to buy them, they can. So yeah, this one, the Formula Hybrid 2017, it has been released at a price of €3.99, fully finished, as far as I understand, with two models, one with the fin, one without. I'll be doing it with the fin because personally I like it. A bit controversial, I know, but I do like the fin. And some other bits and bobs. They've done something with the tyres, showing different textures and things and different wear levels. I have read that, and it comes with a little setup guide. So that's that one. And you can just buy it on their website, which I'll link in the description. Next one is ACFL. Now they're going a bit grander with what they intend. This is €5 and it's going to be on R Factor 2 as well, which is going to be converted by Apex modding, because the physics and the sounds need completely redoing for R Factor 2. But they've done a lot more. Now I was watching a live stream of them modeling the Red Bull car and they've done that very quick, so it's someone who knows what they're doing for sure. But so far these are the cars that they've got completed. So Renault, Ferrari, Force India, Sauber, Haas, Williams, McLaren and Red Bull. The purchase comes with the beta, so I'm going to throw that right out there now. I'm going to be comparing, but caveat, I do want it known that I totally appreciate this is a beta and the do state it's not fully representative of sounds and physics, but I think enough people are interested that they would drop some money on it like I have, so they deserve to see what they're doing basically and what it's about. So yeah, that one's €5, and let's see what they're about. So here we've got the ACFL beta, in Nico Rosberg colours, interestingly. You can tell it's the 2017 beta because it's got the swept-back arrow-like front wing, and the side pods, best viewed from above, that are also swept back. They're done by regulation now. The rear wing, it does look lower. I haven't actually looked at the Mercedes rear wing, but what you find is a lot of sort of got a shape that comes up here, but model looks good, detailed. Looks like an F1 car. Yeah, I think it looks the part, for sure. Be good to see the other ones in the flesh when they're released. And I noticed that the rear wing animation is there for the DRS, which is also good. But that's the ACFL car. And here's the Racing Studios version. Almost immediately, I feel like this is a much more detailed model. I'm immediately noticing the brake cooling ducts and the extra like details on the front wing, and also the barge boards there in the engine cover. There's a lot of detail there. It is obviously the 2017 version with the swept back front wing, and this is the non-fin version, clearly. There's the animation for the DRS up at the back there. I'm not going to knock the other ACFL one too much because it's beta, but I'd definitely like to see more detail when, you know, now I'm looking at this car, I feel like there's more detail. Maybe it's how I'm looking at it, I don't know. And there's that shape I was talking about that was absent from the last model with the curve to the rear wing. Though that's this is kind of a generic look for the 2017 F1 cars. Like I say, in the defense of the other one, I've not actually looked in great detail too much at pictures of the newer cars, but there it is. And here's the Racing Studios version with the shark fin. Personally, I think that looks superb. I love it. I think they look so aggressive. I think they look really sleek. I think it's a good look, personally. And maybe it's this nice carbon effect skin that's on the car as well that helps. But again, I feel like I'm seeing more detail in this front wing. There's actually some detail just behind the front wing there, with some extra aero fins there that direct the airflow, brake ducts. So it's basically the same model, but with the fin, which is absolutely fine, as is the point of having the different ones. But I think all in all, that's a great looking model, with the sensors there on the nose there. I think that looks great. I actually felt it was only fair to come back and have another quick check of this model, and I will hold my hands up and say I was a bit mistaken. It's just that this frontal area looks plain in comparison, but there's definitely some aero work just here. Maybe the skin doesn't make it jump, and I can't really... There is some detail to that badge board for sure, actually, now I'm looking at it. And the little details there, I just didn't want to throw it under the bus needlessly, honesty and everything like that. And there is the brake ducts there and the sensor on the nose. I just didn't really notice it on first pass. The skin doesn't make things pop, which is all good. Bit of feedback there for the guys currently developing it. But it's a good model, it looks good. So here we are, we're in the ACFL 2017 car at Catalunya. I thought it was the best location given what's going on here, or what has been going on here. Steering wheel looks good, sounds good. Letting you guys take it in a bit as well. I have done a few laps in both cars just to familiarise myself a little bit with them. I had a little problem whereby I couldn't see the steering wheel and I thought it was me, but apparently my view decided to change itself into one where I couldn't see the steering wheel. I didn't even know that was possible, so I'm not sure how it happened. Make sure to use the DRS where I can. Yeah, I like the cockpit detail so far. I like the sounds, given that they said they're not final sounds. I think they're good. Force feedback feels connected. I don't feel like I'm floating or anything like that, which is always a plus. It's basically doing what I expect it to. The brakes seem to work. Easily flat through there. feel like this is certainly a good base, definitely something they can release while saying it's a beta. Wow. I'm not sure what that was that just fell on the floor, but it was loud. Overall, I'm happy with it. I'm looking forward to seeing the rest of the cars come from the package. I don't mind paying for mods. I don't mind paying for mods when people put the work in, you know. And I certainly get the impression that work's been put into this by people who have got some idea of what they're doing, and it's not like a rush hack job. Certainly going to be worth €5 once all of the cars are released, that's for sure. But then I suppose if you're only going to buy one mod, which mod do you choose? Maybe by the end of the video we'll be able to give some kind of conclusion on that, but I didn't brake till very late then, but still made the corner. Oh, and he's chucked it. Well, that came from nowhere. I don't know if my rear wing's fallen off at this point. Suppose I'll find out in a moment. Nice texturing on the tyres there. I don't guess that's automatic. I guess they still have to put that in. The ERS number is moving. Not that I know what it particularly means at this point. Ooh, I didn't see a readme or anything like that, so don't compare my times to that of the Ferraris in the test. I know I'm miles off. Good traction. Overall, very drivable and fun. It's good. So what I'll do, I'll just do a flying lap and then I'll switch over to the next car. That's crap, wasn't it? And here we are in the Racing Studios version. So let's see what this has got to offer. I already think that that steering wheel looks incredible. I really do. That is a work of art. I think the sounds are better, but let's not be too harsh on the ACFL one, beta and all. Trying to feel my way into this car. Ooh, hit that sausage curb. Alright, let's get into it a bit. So, DRS. DRS is open, there's a little light there. So I'm looking at the gauges on the right hand side of the steering wheel there. There's the yellow one, which I'm not quite sure what it signifies, but then there is the blue one. And the blue one depletes and replenishes, so I guess that's the ERS one. Answers on a postcard for the yellow one, please. Wow. I'm sure I set the steering wheel rotation to 180 degrees because it's recommended in the README. I guess that's why, because the hand animation goes a bit funky. Ooh. Yeah, I'm a little bit distracted by that, but maybe I set it incorrectly. So, I mean, I guess my immediate impression is in this thing, I feel like I'm sat in an F1 car. Not that I particularly didn't in the other one, this just, it certainly shows why the ACFL version has its beta tag, I think. The sounds to me feel better in here, not that the other ones are bad. Physics feel very similar, I have to say. I'm not feeling a great deal of difference, though. I'm hardly Lewis Hamilton. People will be surprised I said his name. This certainly just looks a more finished product to me. Handling-wise, I'm really not feeling too much difference, if I'm honest. They both feel great, I think. Which I suppose is what it comes down to, but I'm not annoyed I've paid for either. And I'm looking forward to the rest of the ACFL package, that's for sure. There are actually three different ERS modes in this car. so you can have more power from it. Because they have put a nice little readme and setup guide in with the package, which is always welcome. So you've got some idea of where to start with your setups. I haven't tinkered, I've taken them basically out of the box and given them a drive. I don't know if I fell oversteer there. I had a feeling there was some snap oversteer, but... Alright, let's do one lap. And then what I'll do is... I'll put up a lap of each. From outside. Some nice power on oversteer there.
Oh. So, what do we think, sports fans? Well, I think they're both brilliant mods, if I'm honest. I think both have some strengths and some have both have weaknesses, maybe. I think for ACFL, their biggest selling point is that they're going to have the entire field and they're going to be individually modelled. It's not going to be reskins. As you can see just there, you can see on the detail of the nose cone of the McLaren, it's different to, say, the Renault. They're definitely sort of modelling each one faithfully as they go along. Whereas I feel that as it stands, granted, ACFL is in beta with their 2017 version. The Formula Hybrid from Racing Studio is a more rounded, finished product, but both are worth your money. I think the sounds from the Formula Hybrid are better, but again, beta, they said it's not a final representation of sounds, which is fine. Physics wise, like I said, while driving, it's not as if really I have the ability to find the ragged edge I never have had, but they didn't feel all that different from each other. I like that they both have the ERS charging light at the back there that blinks when you're under braking, and that they have the DRS fully animated. I think it looks good on both cars. So all in all, really, I've come to no conclusion with them. I think they're both worth their asking price. If you're a fan of Formula One, you probably want to pick them up anyway. But really, I just thought I'd put the video out there to show you guys, currently as it stands, what they both look like. I will most definitely revisit the ACFL version when they hit full release, because I think it deserves it, and I do want everyone to sort of take it with a pinch of salt if they're put off by this beta version. But seeing as they're asking money for it, I think it's only fair that someone put something out there to show off what they're producing. So anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and give us a subscribe and comment on your feelings on it. Maybe the political situation with modding Formula One cars, and what you think to the two mods. I think they're great. So yeah, I'll see you soon, guys, and thanks for joining me again. Thanks.